टेल मी, थिंक अबाउट इट, आर यू अ फिजिकल क्वांट, कैन यू बी मेजर्ड?
यस मैम,
हाउ कैन यू बी मेजर्ड? यू मीन वेट ऑफ योर बॉडी, इज इट, और
हाइट,
हाइट? ओके, हाइट, वेट. सो यू आर थिंकिंग दैट हाइट एंड वेट दे कैन बी मेजर्ड. सो हाइट इज अ फिजिकल क्वांटिटी एंड वेट इज अ फिजिकल क्वांटिटी, वेयर इज यू आरंट. दैट्स व्हाट आई एम ट्राइंग टू से. द वन दैट कैन बी मेजर्ड दैट इज अ फिजिकल क्वांटिटी, बट यू आर नॉट द फिजिकल क्वांटिटी. योर हाइट एंड योर वेट इज बींग मेजर्ड, राइट? यू आर नॉट फिजिकल क्वांटिटी. Your age is being measured. Age is a physical. Anything that can be measured is a physical. Tell me, emotions or feelings of a person, can they be measured? No. Right? You cannot measure such kind of intelligence of a person. You can't measure such kind of things. IQ is measurable quantity. So that is physical quantity. Okay? That's a different thing. It's a quotient that is based on how you are figuring out things, how fast you are figuring that. I'm not going to talk about that. Can you understand the difference between non-physical quantity and physical quantity? I'll give you a question. Try to think whether it's physical quantity or not. Okay. Speed of a body. Speed of a body. Is it a physical quantity or not physical quantity? Can speed of a body be measured? Yes, guys, or no?
Yes, ma'am.
It can be measured. What about you, Harshit, Rohit, other? You have to answer.
Feed. I did not understand, ma'am.
Where you didn't understand? You should ask me whenever you.
No, the question, ma'am. Question.
Oh, I'm asking, is speed of a body a physical quantity or not? Can speed be measured or not?
The blood pressure and it can be
speed,
measured.
Speed can be measured, car speed can be measured, truck speed can be measured. So it is measured and its unit is either meter per second or kilometer per hour. So it is a physical quantity, right? How about, let's say, heart rate. Can it be measured?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes,
how about,
ma'am.
How about dancing skills of a person?
No, ma'am.
You can't measure. I'll measure with respect to Prabhudeva. I mean, such kind of things are not possible. You can't measure. There's no scale for measuring, right? So anything that can be measured, only that qualifies as a physical quantity. So if anyone asks, it's a physical quantity, make sure. Anything that can be measured is a physical quantity. So if one particular quantity is given, temperature is given, think in your mind, can I measure temperature? Yes, I can measure. Means that's a physical quantity. Okay. First important thing in units and dimensions is what is physical quantity. If you know what's physical quantity, you can understand the chapter better. Okay. For the physical quantity, see, length, unit we are saying meters. Mass, unit we are saying kg. Time, unit we are saying second. And force, unit we are saying it's Newton. Okay. So these units are standard units. Are you understanding? Which are specifically for this particular physical. Meter is always the unit of length. If I'll say that meter is the unit of temperature or meter is the unit of force, I will be not, I mean, it's like I have no idea about what I'm talking about. Just for the sake of it, I'm talking about it. So uneducated person will not know what is the length unit, what is mass unit. Such kind of people will say whatever they want. No? So that's very important to have knowledge of what is standard unit. Anywhere you go, you want to represent it in standard unit. Okay. So how many actually are there in this program? Can you just tell me? Again, one student has joined. Navtej, were you present in the last IIT session? Hello, Navtej, can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am, I'm not able to log in, ma'am.
Okay, were you present yesterday in the session?
Ma'am, I was present yesterday also.
All right. Okay, guys, still here, is there any doubt? Navtej, I will request you to look into our online recording. Till where you have missed, you can catch up, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Any doubts you have, can I erase whatever is on the slide?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now see guys, I'm going to talk about standard unit. Let's say mass is measured in kg. Let's say that 1 kg is here. Now I went to the market. I want to buy 10 kgs of rice. I want to buy 10 kg of rice. I know I'm buying 10 kg of rice because I am buying 1 kg of rice 10 times. Means 1 kg is contained 10 times. Then it becomes a 10 kg. Okay. So what we mean over here is standard unit is this one, not multiplier. 10 kg is not standard unit. 1 kg is a standard unit. This is its multiplier. So see, read this statement. To measure a physical quantity, we need a standard of the same quantity, which is the unit. Okay. Suppose mass means kg. Suppose length means meter. Now, this point you make a note of it. It means the number of times the standard unit is contained in that physical quantity. In my particular physical quantity, that is the amount of rice I am measuring, 10 kg I am saying means 10 times this 1 kg is contained in here. Let's say volume, I'm going to the market, I want to buy, let's say, so many packets of milk and I want to distribute it to some poor people. So this is the volume. Volume I'm saying is how many liters of milk I'm buying is 15 liters. So 15 packets, let's say. 15 liters means 1 liter is contained. How many times? 15 times 1 liter is contained. So here 1 liter is what? Standard unit. 15 is what? Times it's contained. Okay, did you understand the meaning? This is the standard unit, not this. Common confusion will be that whether 15 liters is standard or 1 liter. This is a standard. Okay, for this, a multiplier is added and will give us the quantity which we require. Okay, all the units and their respective, all the physical quantities and their respective units also I'll teach you. No need to worry. Starting from length, everything I'll teach you. Don't worry. So did you understand what is meaning of standard unit? Standard unit is some quantity, some physical quantity, which can be having a multiplier to give the required quantity we are measuring. So obviously every time we won't take 1 liter, right? Maybe there are situations where you want only 1 liter. That's okay. But sometimes you go and take number or magnitude of it. Say you went to the shop and you want to buy 100 grams of gold. Means 1 gram is contained. Sorry, 1,000 I wrote. No, 1 gram of gold is contained 1,000 times over here. So 1 gram here is a standard unit. Okay, make sure you understand which is standard unit, which is multiplier. Okay, moving to the next. So if I want to call a particular unit as a standard unit, these are the qualities it should have. Okay, first of all, it should be well defined, and it should be in such a way that well defined means no ambiguity should be there. Anyone who looks at the unit shouldn't say that, "Arey, why this is the unit? Why it couldn't be something else?" Right? So it should be well defined. Means ambiguity shouldn't be there. Ambiguity means doubts. Doubts shouldn't arise as to why that has been defined in this way. Right? First point it should be is it should be well defined. Next, it should be of convenient size. When I say convenient size, it should be neither too large nor too small. Meaning to say, see, a tailor wants to take a measurement of a model and he has to carry a measuring tape in his pocket. That's a portable size. Portable means carried from one place to another. So now, if the measuring, let's just assume that the measuring tape is very huge. It's like as big as a suitcase. Will it be easy for him to carry it around? No, right? So we need it to be of convenient size. Based on our usage, it should be more and more convenient. Okay. What should be more and more convenient? A unit. Next, it shouldn't change with time. Obviously, it should not change with time. You cannot say that I will use 1 glass of water for measuring the mass of something, because water will evaporate with the heat with a rise in temperature. Such things will happen. Perishable things we shouldn't use. So, see, it should be easily reproducible. So, more and more, for example, you have a plastic scale, small plastic scale reads 10 centimeter. The long scale reads 30 centimeter, right? So, how many ever I want, I can produce this such kind of scales. Are you understanding? So, it's easily reproducible. These are just the characteristics. Obviously, it should be internationally acceptable. And it should be, this is very important point, it should be imperishable, as in it shouldn't be destroyable. No matter how many times it got destroyed, we should be able to easily reproduce it again. Measuring tape is easily reproducible. A weight of 1 kg, which the weighing balance uses, is easily reproducible. Right? A clock, which is measuring time, is easily reproducible. Right? Like that. If you look at all the different things, you can make a note of it if you want. Well-defined convenient size, easily reproducible, internationally acceptable, and imperishable or non-destroyable. Also, it shouldn't change with time. Okay. Okay, guys, is it done or not done?
1 minute.
Okay. Is it done? You will have to let me know.
Done,
ma'am. Not yet, ma'am.
I think he's writing Ramayana. Okay, never mind. Okay. So I want, anyway, he's writing, so I'm telling you this. Be very open when you're having any doubt. Basically, in physics, one doubt will give rise to 100 questions. So, as and when you get the doubt, even if you feel it super silly, I am not your school teacher. I am your other physics teacher. So, you can always ask whatever doubt it may be. Ma'am, why sky is blue? It's okay. I will answer. Okay? Always try to ask more doubts. See, there may be something which you ask. I may or may not know. I will also learn in that process. Okay? Always ask more doubts. I am very happy if you ask more doubts and explore. That's the nature of exploring, right? I have to be fed up. That much doubts you have to ask me and develop the love for physics. That's how you'll develop the love for physics. Anyway, now you learned what is physical quantity. What is physical quantity? Any quantity that can be measured, right? Anything that can be measured can count as a physical quantity. Now, physical, very important, guys. From here, the actual chapter starts. Every physical quantity can be distinguished into two types. Let me use a pen. You know this one thing, that humans will come under the classification. See, there is a crocodile. Let's say crocodile is here. Prabhat, now he is joining. Let's say crocodile is there. Crocodile counts as what? Amphibian, we say, right? Or you can say fish is there. Fish counts as an aquatic creature. If you look at humans, terrestrial, kind of things are there, no? Who live in land and water? Amphibian. Who live only in water? Aquatic. Terrestrial means only on the land. So we are classifying the living creatures based in this way. Why we are classifying? So that some order is developed in between these, so that we do not mix up the fish and the humans and everything together. So some kind of order is created. Even more order is there in 9th class, you will learn. So it will be based on what do you say, your I don't want to discuss it now. Anyway, humans are in vertebrates, invertebrates, so many things are there, how they classify. Now, I'll erase these all. Like that only, for organizing our physical quantities, we have separated them into two categories. One is called as fundamental quantities, one is called as derived quantities. Prabhat, try to catch up from here. Whatever you have missed, just go through the video, okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, fundamental quantities and derived quantity. What is a physical quantity? Any quantity that can be measured. Any quantity that can be measured is physical quantity. Now, those quantities, whichever can we see, so many are there. Length can be measured, force can be measured, acceleration, speed, mass, all of these can be, time can be measured, temperature can be measured, pressure, just now we learned, pressure also can be measured. These all things, volume, should be classified in such a way that we don't have much confusion. Now, so many I have listed, all of them are say in the same category, means it's a little different. Some way we should segregate, right? We are segregating in this way. Very important. Fundamental and derived. Fundamental quantities are those quantities which are independent. Let me just show you. They are independent, okay? Derived quantities are dependent on fundamental. See, they are independent, or they do not depend on any other physical quantity for being measured. What is the meaning? I'll explain. Don't worry. Fundamental quantities are independent in nature, okay? They don't depend on another quantity for being measured. Whereas, derived quantities will depend on fundamental quantities for being measured. Let's look at the examples, we'll get a clarity. See. See these all, you, one second. Let me use the pen. So, see this kg. Can I further simplify kg? No. Can I further simplify second? No. These are the fundamental units we are looking at. Look at this one. I can simplify as meter and second. Separate quantity, separate quantity. Meter cube is given over here. Meter cube is there. That is volume. Volume is measured in meter cube or liters. I can further simplify it as meter into meter into meter. Okay. Meter per square, unit of acceleration, that is. Meter is first of all one unit, second and second. So it is depending on three units for being measured. Whereas look at these guys, they are not even meter counts, meter, kg, second, Kelvin. So all of these, now they are individually existing. They do not depend on anyone else for being measured. Whereas here I need length and I need time for measuring speed. I need three times the mass. I need, see, volume means L into B into H. Length into breadth into height. Meter, meter, meter gave me meter cube. So it needs three times of length. So it is dependent on length thrice. Likewise here. So if you see different, just now we had seen pressure. It is the force per unit area. Newton per meter square. See, there's force also, there's meter square. Make a note of it quickly, guys. Fundamental quantities are, which are independent. One more definition I will give you. They cannot be further simplified. Okay, they cannot be further simplified. Okay, this can be simplified. In fact, they can be expressed in the form of fundamental. Okay. Clear? They can't be further simplified. This can be simplified. I think I'll use black. Okay, clear. Made a note of it, guys. Now I'll show you how many fundamental.
1 minute, ma'am.
Okay. Calm down. No worry. Even if I'm going fast, you should stop me like this so that I will know. No need to panic.
Done, ma'am.
Okay. Others, how about you, Prabhat and Rohit and...
Ma'am, 1 minute.
Done, ma'am.
Okay, okay. I'll take some time to learn your names. Renita, Navtej. Rishita is done, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. No hurry, nothing to rush. These are the basics. I need you to go slow with them so that you understand. What is physical? Keep it in your head. What is physical quantity? Any quantity. Oh, sorry. 1 second. Any quantity that can be measured is called as a physical quantity. That physical quantity is of two types. One is fundamental and one is derived. Fundamental is independent of other quantities. So you don't want, in fundamental quantities, any quantity which is fundamental. Let's say length is fundamental. If I'm saying that length is fundamental, length doesn't depend on any other quantity for being measured. So its unit is meter. It is a fundamental quantity. Like that. What we mean is that. Derived quantities, you take area. I'll say area's unit is meter square. Meter into meter. It is depending two times on length for being measured. So it is a derived quantity. All right. I'm moving further.
Yes, sir.
So this is not required right now, but questions are being asked as multiple choice. I think you know in your MCQ question, multiple choice questions you have in your Olympiads. So I just want to, you to know it, the basics of this. Whereas we are not using these today, just know the basics. So different system of units were there initially. One is the CGS system. See, I will tell you the trick of it, then you will get an idea. So always remember, first comes length, then comes the mass, then comes the time during the system of units. So length in the form of C means, can I say centimeter? G, mass in the form of G. First of all, mass is actually kilograms, what we know. So obviously this G means grams and S is always seconds. So CGS systems was first introduced in France and it was based on the measurement as centimeter, gram and second. So anywhere that they measured length, they always measured in centimeter. Whenever they measured mass, they measured it in grams. And whenever they measured time, it was in seconds. Are you understanding? This is how CGS system went about. Let's see the next system. We have MKS. Now you tell me MKS. Sorry. MKS. Same that way you try to figure out M.
Meter.
Very good.
Meter, kilogram and second.
Meter, kilogram and second. Okay guys, M, K and S stands respectively for length, meter, K for kg and S for second. This is also based in France. Okay. Both of these are based in France and they have, so you can see the, I have written it down over here. Centimeter, gram and second. Here meter, kilogram and second were their respective fundamental units. That's all. In the system of units, this was the way they represented. They didn't talk about other units. They didn't give preference to other units. Both of these were developed in France. Now there's something new over here. F, P, S. F stands for foot, P stands for pound, and S stands for second. Make a note of it. Foot, pound, and second. Okay. If you want, you can make a note of one more thing. Actually, they will ask conversions. I will ask you conversions. So write down. Hurry. 1 second. I'll give you the value also. I think centimeter and meter, you know. Suppose I'm having 1 meter. I want to represent it in centimeter. I will write it as 100 centimeter. Do you know this? I'm just,
yes, ma'am.
Conversions. If you want, make a note of it. 1 kg, kilogram in grams, kilo meaning 1,000, 1000 grams. Seconds you don't need. I'm talking now about foot and pound. These two are new to you. So you make a note of it. 1 foot in meters is 0.305 meters. Okay, you can just take 0.3 meters. That's okay. Okay. 1 pound. Pound means in kg, I'll talk about it. It's almost 0.5 kg, close to 0.5 kg. Remember as almost 0.5 kg. Because in our exams, we won't write 0.5455 because it's time waste. Usually, we'll just take for the option closest to 0.5. You'll measure, multiplier, you'll use 0.5, and whichever option is very close to this one, you will substitute. Okay, make a note of these. Okay, I'll give you one question. Convert 20 pound to kg. Second one, convert 300 meter into feet. Two things you have to do. First of all, I want to convert pound to kg. So whenever you do this question, I'll show you one you take as homework. You want to convert pound to kg. So you first write down pound. 1 pound is 0.5. I told you to take 0.5 kg. So I can write 20 instead of 1 pound. Instead of the pound, I can write into 0.5. Now it becomes kg. Yeah? Tell me for this one. 20 into 0.5, how much is that? 10. 10 kg. Now look at this, 300 meters. So I want to convert meters to feet. So 1 meter I want. 1 meter is 1 by 0.305 feet. I will just take 300 for convenience sake. So 300 into 1 by 0.300 is okay, not needed. Then I can write it in the form of feet. See, what you want to convert, That one part you find out first. This will count.
Ma'am, can you repeat the second one?
Wait, again I'll write here. You want to convert meter to feet. So you want this relation. I have given you feet to meter relation. I want meter to feet. So can I say 1 meter is, send it to denominator by cross multiplication. Can I say 1 meter is 1 by 0.3 feet. Guys, are you understanding? Now are you?
Yes, ma'am.
So in the place of 1 meter, how many meters? 300 meters. In the place of meter, let me write 1 by 0.3. 0.305 I will not take, just 0.3 I'll take. Because in our Olympiad, we want to just eliminate these all things. Take the closest value to whatever you get. You will not get exact answer, of course. You won't get exact answer. So you want to cancel out this. How to cancel? Let me multiply by 10 and divide by 10 so that point is removed. Now we have 3000 by 3. Answer is 1000. However you want to solve from here, however you feel comfortable to solve, you solve it. No need to do like me. So what is this 1000 feet? One more I'll give you, take it as homework. Let me give 9 meters to feet. Convert 930 meters to feet. This is a homework. Next class I'll ask the answer. Okay, moving further, guys. Now we are, these are all the system of units which we used to use earlier, right? Now we are going to use something else. And before going to that, I want to just quickly give a revision of what we have discussed. We are in the chapter units and measurements. Units and measurements is very vital when we are looking at physics, because everywhere it has to be acceptable. See, you can see these diagrams which we saw. Length is measured in meters, measured in kg. Volume is measured in liters. Temperature is measured in Kelvin or degree Celsius. Okay, we learned why is there a need for measurement. All over the world, physicists are performing experiments. Not necessarily physicists. Many people are performing experiments for accurate results. You need to have the same unit. You need to have the same way of measurement. So to do that, we need to learn what is a unit, what is a measurement, right? Why do we need units also? We have understood. If one guy is measuring some, suppose he says, I don't want to measure in your meters and kg and all, I will pick one stone. And how many ever mangoes, you want one mango? It should be rated with my stone. This stone is the standard. Then you will never go and buy from that guy. You think that he is crazy. So we need a standard so that, you know, everything runs smoothly. Next, what is physical quantity? That can be measured is a physical quantity. Length, mass, time, these all can be measured. So they are all physical quantities. Standard unit also was discussed. These are the desirable qualities that should be there for any unit to be called as a standard unit. It should be well defined. It should have a convenient size. It shouldn't be too large or shouldn't be too small. It should be easily, we should be able to easily carry it from place to place, right? Shouldn't change with time. It should be easily reproducible. That is many more, what do you say, counter copies of it should be made. It should be internationally acceptable. And this word, if you don't know, imperishable, it means it shouldn't be destroyable. It shouldn't be destroyable means we should use vibranium or very hard substance to make it. That's not the point over there. He's trying to say, then if something happens and if it got destroyed, again, we should be able to make it like that. Don't use any, suppose fossil fuels, they can be exhausted. Such kind of things don't use for defining, he's trying to say. Some earlier days, they used to use, I'll show you an example. Earlier days, they used to use logs of wood for measuring the weight. Okay. Now, log of wood varies from place to place. Also varies from type of tree to type of tree, right? So you can't use such kind of things. It has to be internationally acceptable and imperishable. Log of wood is both ways, it's not possible. Not internationally acceptable. And it's quite easily perishable. Little bit of fire will destroy that. Then we learn types of units, fundamental and derived. Fundamental units, fundamental quantity have units called as fundamental units. Derived quantities have units called as derived units. Okay, fundamental quantities are independent on another physical quantity. That is, they are existing individually, whereas derived quantities depend on fundamental quantity for being measured. System of units are of three types, CGS, MKS, and FPS. CGS, centimeter, gram, second, MKS, meter, kilogram, second, and FPS is foot, pound, and second. This is the most important part of today's session, this particular slide, okay? Last, I think we have 10 minutes. Very carefully observe. Okay. Now, our fundamental units, whichever we have been found from this one only. It's called as SI unit. SI meaning system international system of units or system international. Okay. This was given from a conference which happened in around 1980s or so, 1970s, I think. And this was giving implementation, or this was giving emphasis on, because of there were different types of systems, FPS, FPS was introduced by whom? British. France introduced your MKS as well as CGS. So different systems are there and different countries are using different systems. That was the problem that was raised in the conference. And then the conference was based on weights and measures. Okay, so this was the problem that was raised. And then they said, okay, let us classify some particular quantities as fundamental. The remaining will be called as derived. Sorry, derived. All right. So let's see, who are the fundamental quantities? What about them? I told you, fundamental quantities, any quantity does not depend on another quantity for being measured. Length, first fundamental quantity. The unit of length is meter. SI unit is meter. Symbol for writing meter is small m. Next one is mass. SI unit is kilogram. Symbol for writing it is 5 kilograms. Suppose I have 5 kilogram. I'll write in few ways. You tell me which way is correct. 5 kg. All are correct also, you can tell. Kilogram. And fourth option I gave as 5. This is capital K and this is small g. Which of the options is correct? In the first option, small k, small g. Second option, capital K, capital G. Regular kilogram spelling and one is capital K, G. Which of the option do you think is actually correct? Let me tell you, only first one. Option. Only one option is correct.
The first one.
First one.
Sure. So guys, we have to understand that some specific way of the specific ways to, is there to write. I'll teach you how to write this unit and all also. I'll teach you. Kg has to be written like this, small k, small g. Capital K, capital when we write is whenever it is a scientist name. See, Kelvin is a scientist name. Ampere is a scientist name. Candela, I'll talk about Candela later. So these are written as capital. Whenever it's not a scientist name, usually we will not write it in caps. Is it clear? Now look at the next fundamental quantity, time. Time is measured in seconds. Okay, you have temperature, temperature measured in Kelvin. And you have electric current ampere. Okay, electric current is measured in ampere. Luminous intensity is important. It's measured in candela, CD. I'll define them, don't worry. Amount of substance is measured in, this is important, mole, mole, and representation is mol only. Okay, first of all, make a note of it. As you're making note of it, I will define it for you. Length of substance, you don't need. Mass, time, temperature, these things you're familiar with, at least you have heard about what it means. Length is if you are measuring in the longitudinal way or in the other way. Suppose you have a rectangle, you are able to measure the length of the rectangle. Nothing to define in that. Right? Mass also in the same way, time also in the same way, temperature. Now, one thing is commonly people get confused with degree Celsius and Kelvin. See, Kelvin is the SI unit. Nowadays, we only focus on SI unit. So, Kelvin is the one we talk as fundamental unit. Okay? Don't talk about degree Celsius. It's not fundamental. Even though it's more commonly used. Why it's commonly used is it's easily accessible. See, actually, the Celsius, I'm showing the Celsius scale and Kelvin scale. Celsius scale 0 degree, 1 degree, 2 degree goes on up to 100 degree. Okay, we should say 100 degree Celsius, 2 degree Celsius. Right? Kelvin scale, whatever is 0 degree on Celsius will be 273 Kelvin. So, 1 degree will be 274. It doesn't start at 0, it starts at 273. This will be 275. Like that, it goes on.
373.
Very good. 373 Kelvin. Now, the reason why we are using Celsius more often is because representing, see, suppose I'm talking about 30 degrees. 30 degrees means how much? Tell me quickly, guys. 303 Kelvin. Is it?
Yes, ma'am.
So, is it easy for me to write 30 degree or just for convenience sake, I'm going to write 30 degrees. smaller one this is. See, 100 degrees Celsius is much simple than 373 Kelvin. That's why we are using Celsius more often. But the actual way, actual defined one is Kelvin. Okay, remember that. Why it's Kelvin, all that, one more day I'll discuss the details of that. Next, come to electric current.
Ma'am, then why is Fahrenheit used, ma'am, to measure the...
There are different scales. See, for example, I'll give you a substance. If you'll take nichrome, nichrome is an alloy of nickel and chromium. I don't think you know those, but anyway, it's an alloy. Means you're mixing two or more elements and making an alloy. So nichrome has very high temperature. So up to high temperature, it is going to stay without melting. So we say that it has a high melting point. Now, for high melting point, you will use scale of measuring temperature. So as the sensitivities are decreasing, see, for example, our temperature, human body temperature, we're measuring in degrees Celsius. If I look at the boiling point of water, or if I look at boiling point of something, in Kelvin I'm measuring. So different scales are convenient for different type of measures, but the standard one is what? Kelvin. Remember it, okay? There are different scales like Fahrenheit you have, Riemer scale, you have Celsius, you have Kelvin. See, four. All four we'll discuss in detail and their conversions, everything we will have. We have it in this chapter, don't worry. Eventually. Now you have electric current. Electric current is represented with symbol I. Okay, the symbol that is used for electric current is I. Its unit is in A. Suppose I say current is equal to 5 ampere. Current equals to 12 ampere. Do you understand this? Definition of current, if you want, make a note. Rate of flow of charge. It's like this. Current is charge flowing per unit time. You don't know charge, you know time. I don't want to discuss right now. Just write the formula. Rate of flow of charge. Charge is coulombs. Charge is measured in coulombs. Time is measured in seconds. So unit of current is either coulombs per second or ampere. Preferably ampere because it's a SI unit and it is a more importantly, it's a fundamental unit. Now you may get a doubt. Ma'am, you told that it should not depend on two units for being measured. So let me clear it out for you. Current is not depending on charge and time. Actually, charge is depending on current and time. So charge equals to ampere into second. So ampere and second, both are fundamental. See, ampere is fundamental, second is fundamental. So this is the derived quantity. Okay? How to check which is derived, which is fundamental, I'm showing you. So first we have length. Meter, mass is kg, time is in seconds, temperature is in Kelvin, electric current is in ampere, luminous intensity, luminous meaning brightness, amount of brightness is nothing but luminous intensity. Okay, remember one thing, luminous intensity is for only monochromatic light. What is meaning of monochromatic? Mono meaning single, chroma meaning color. So, single colored light, when spaced in some kind of a medium, how much is its brightness? How far is its brightness spreading and how much is the intensity? That is what is luminous intensity. Okay, this will come in optics chapter or light chapter. So, this is what is luminous. Basic definition, if you know enough, it is just the measure of brightness, measure of monochromatic light brightness. It's measured in what? Candela. Candela is again scientist name. Ma'am, you told scientist name will be capital letter. Yes, I did. But candela is using two alphabets, so that's why small. Single alphabet means capital. Now, amount of substance, very important one. Actually, very important one. Out of all, I think that I will emphasize more on amount of substance. Quickly, guys, only 1 minute I have. Amount of substances, when we are talking about, see, atoms and all, they are not visible to our naked eye. We can't see electron, we can't see proton, all these things, bands, you know. So those, when we are measuring, let's say I want 12 grams of copper, or if I'm saying I want some 14 grams of nitrogen, whenever I say like this, we can't see the atoms, so we can't measure it, right? Sodium, 11 grams of sodium I want. You can't measure it. So that time, this concept is coming into picture. So mole is the unit for measuring subatomic particles, and those such very small particles we are using amount of substance. It is, write down the definition. We'll continue from the amount of substance in next class. Just write the definition. The number of atoms contained in 12 grams of C12 carbon. Write down, actually write like this. One mole is defined as number of atoms contained in 12 grams of C12 carbon. One mole is nothing but unit of amount of substance. Amount of substance here is the physical quantity. Mole is the unit. Symbol is MOL. Is it clear? Guys, is there any doubt till here?
Any, no, ma'am.
Any doubt? Hope it's clear to you. Are you understanding? Is physics interesting?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Okay. I will see you in the next session. I have asked you, I have given you only one question. That is conversion 930 meters into feet. This is the one homework question I have given you. The video lecture will be available. Our same video lecture will be available in our myschool24by7.com. Okay, if anyone has doubt, you can call our team. Right? Thank you, yes, guys. I will end the session now.
Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, thank you.